Well, half a person came from, I guess, my friendship with Rob Chuter. We wanted to work on something together, and he sort of emailed me one day and said, "Hey, how about a show about the Smiths? What about a one-man show about the Smiths?" And he knew that I'd loved the Smiths and had a great passion for the Smiths over many years. And he, of course, did too as well. So it seemed like a good project. It seemed like something that we could work on together and create a piece of theatre. So I started thinking about it, and I guess what came to me was a period in my life and a couple of relationships, I guess, I had, or friendships that I had. One with ex-girl, or, you know, or the Salome character, and the other, I guess, with the Rick character. And although the play is not completely factual, or the play is not based completely on real life, certainly there are moments from truth, moments from reality, which I've woven through the text. I'm not going to tell you which ones they are exactly, but I can tell you that the Rick character is based on Nick Enright. I think it's important to say that. Nick is a wonderful, wonderful Australian playwright who died sadly a number of years ago, died of skin cancer. And Nick wrote Black Rock, he wrote Quartet for Rigoletto, so many wonderful Australian plays, St. James Infirmary, you can go on and on. But Rick, as William says in the play, was a really beautiful person. He was an incredibly giving person, incredibly caring person. And Nick put up with so much shit and so much crap for me when I was just like William, just completely self-obsessed and full of just nonsense. And Rick was really patient and calm and supportive and listened to me. And I don't think I'd be standing here right now. I don't know if I'd ever be on this planet if it wasn't for Nick Enright and the care and the guidance and the unconditional love that Nick gave me. And the play is very much, although it's set in Melbourne, it's actually really based, or the real story happened in Sydney, and Nick lived in a place in Newtown, in Horton Street, Newtown, and that's where I used to go to and be devastated, if you like. Nick didn't introduce me to the Smiths. I think Nick would have hated the Smiths, and Nick would have much rather liked to listen to some opera. But Nick, a lot of the other incidents, I guess, are real. Or close to reality. I'm not going to tell you how much was exactly real. The other character from life is very important. He's called Francois in the play, but he's actually George Ogilvie, who was Nick's dear friend. And George is an incredible man, a wonderful man, a great Australian director. And I guess George also shapes the text in a way as well too. So that was very important, that relationship with Nick, that friendship with Nick, that guidance and support he gave me. And also my relationship and my bond with George Ogilvie is really important in the text. In terms of the Salome character, I mean, she, I guess, is an amalgamation of a number of different people. I wouldn't say she's one particular person. She's just, as William says in the text, just one of the many people that I was obsessed about at that time for X number of reasons. I'm a little bit surprised. I've just come out of seeing the show here tonight, and I'm a little bit surprised how explicit the text is. It certainly doesn't hold a lot back there. It's very full on at times. I'm not sure if I can claim those sexual Olympics to such an extraordinary standard as William does in the play, but it's quite explicit. But I guess at the time that's what it was like. It was about the discovery of first love, of first passion, of the first really sexual connection with someone, I guess, that extraordinary time and that time in my life. And when I think back to that, I think, not, that's the thing, the Salome character is not the important character. The important person in that period of my life was Nick Enright, and how sad it was that he was taken away from us. And a man who was so much to a whole generation of Australian actors, directors and writers, and gave so much to the craft, to the art. So yeah, that's kind of how the show came about. We had a season in Adelaide, and then brought it to Sydney with David. David did a wonderful job, and now I've just come out of seeing Mark's extraordinary performance. Amazing performance. So he brings William to life in a way that is just very true and very real and very honest. And you know, sometimes you just want to slap William and say, Jesus, wake up, you know? You're just so immature, just grow up. But you know, I guess that's what's happened during the play, that he does grow up and he does become begins to become someone who is a bit more mature. He begins to become a man, I guess, and he realizes the things that are really important in his life. And, you know, also the visuals are absolutely extraordinary. And I was amazed as a Smiths fan, because I am a Smiths fan, I'm a huge Smiths fan, and it's wonderful to hear all the songs being sung, but to see all those incredible visuals of all those LP covers, some that I've never even seen before, were absolutely incredible. So that, and to hear the songs and the beautiful arrangements of the songs, Colin Berwick's done an amazing job with the songs, to hear that, to see, you know, Mark's incredible performance, so my words brought to life. I mean, it's a great thing as a playwright, and it's very moving. You know, it's very moving to go back to that time, to think back to that house in Portland Street, to think back to the, you know, little old record player, and to think back is really quite extraordinary and quite confronting in a way as well too. But if there's anything that we've achieved in this play, yes, we've introduced a whole stack of people to Morrissey and to the work of the Smiths, which is really beautiful. But if we've done anything in this show, it's to pay some tribute to the great legacy of Nick Enright.